Welcome friends, welcome to our channel. Today in Muslim law, our topic is maintenance. We are going to understand what is maintenance, what are the principle of maintenance, what are the obligation involved in maintenance, and what are the right of maintenance, and what are the condition when maintenance of wife ceases or can be stopped. What are the ground for separate maintenance when wife can ask for separate maintenance? And what are the provisions for maintenance of divorced wife? And what about maintenance of children? And what about maintenance of illegitimate children? So we will discuss all these things. So let us start one by one. What is maintenance? So in Arabic, maintenance means nafaqa. And nafaqa literally means what a person spends on his family. So it is quite relevant, the word maintenance or nafaqa, which is related to directly the spending on the family. In general, maintenance include food, clothes, or lodging arrangement. But in general, it is called food, arrangement of food only. However, all these three things are included. So under Muslim law, a man is bound to maintain his wife and minor children irrespective of mean, provided he is not indigent and he is also obliged to maintain his other relative from whom he can inherit the property in law if he has means to do and they are indigent. Means we can summarize the absolute responsibility of maintenance of a man is for his wife and his minor children. So these are the absolute liability. Absolute responsibility or liability means whether he has means of earning or not, he has to take care of minimum these two categories, wife and minor children. Furthermore, if he is capable, he is not indigent, he is not weak, he is also obliged to maintain other relative from he in law is supposed to get inheritance property. And if he is having servant and slaves, it is also his responsibility to maintain them. So what are the general principle of maintenance as per Muslim law? In Muslim law, a person is entitled to maintenance, means he is entitled to get maintenance. You're talking to whom maintenance will be given if he has no property of his own as a source of any income. So if first condition fulfilled, then second condition is the person to whom maintenance is to be given should be in relation to the obligor in a prohibited degree. Okay, and wife and children are obviously there, but if any other person to be included for maintenance, the person should be in prohibited degree to whom he or she is expecting maintenance. And third one is the obligor or the person to whom maintenance will be given by should be in position, should be in capable that he can give maintenance to these. If these three conditions are fulfilled, liability of maintenance arises. So what are the obligation of maintenance? We will see in detail. The first one is maintenance of wife. Second one is relative in prohibited degree, children, and in Muslim, as per Muslim law, grandchildren, aged parent are also obligation of maintenance. And third one, as usual, we discuss if he is having servant and slaves, because slaves was age old custom. Now it is very less prevalent, but it is again a liability of obligation to maintain them. Now let us discuss in detail maintenance right of wife. As we discussed before, maintenance of wife is absolute. And these are the two conditions that husband has to give maintenance to the wife in any condition. If she is fulfilling these two conditions, if she has attained age of puberty, age of puberty in Muslim is 15 years. So age of puberty, attaining age of puberty means she is capable for consummation or cohabitation or sexual intercourse. That is called attaining age of puberty. And second one is she has submitted herself to husband and obey all his lawful commands. If these conditions are fulfilled at the end of wife, she is entitled for the maintenance. I hope it is clear. And what are the conditions, what are the ground when maintenance of wife can be stopped or ceases? The right of maintenance of wife ceases if all these eight conditions, any of them are getting into notice. If she is minor, means if she has not attained age of puberty or she is incapable of consummation, as we discussed before. Second is, if she refuses to access herself to her husband on all reasonable time, then also maintenance of wife can be stopped. If she is disobedient and she has never visited husband house, then also she cannot claim maintenance. If she refused to cohabit without reasonable cause, if there is reasonable cause, okay, but without reasonable cause, if she is keep refusing for cohabitation, then also such right goes away. Further, sixth one, if she abandoned conjugal house means house of husband where this both husband wife are supposed to live, has abandoned without reasonable cause, or desert him, or eloping with any other person. So these are the eight ground where maintenance of wife will be ceased and she is not entitled for that. However, what are the ground wife can ask for separate residence as well as maintenance also from her husband? So these are the three grounds: cruelty of husband. So if husband is doing cruelty to his wife, wife has right to ask separate residence as well as maintenance of wife. So cruelty is again very wide terminology, however nowhere defined in the law, but in general mental or physical cruelty both are considered ground for separate residence and maintenance of wife. So physical cruelty means beating the wife, not necessary there is injury, visible injury, but beating is enough. And mental cruelty also, if a wife is in torture or feeling insecure living with husband, then also she has right to separate residence and maintenance. And second is, if husband did second marriage and the first wife is not comfortable with second marriage, in that case also in Muslim law she has right for separate residence and maintenance as well. And if there are again disagreement with husband on certain issues and they are justified, she can ask for separate residence as well as maintenance. Now the most important and debatable part is, what are the rights of maintenance of divorced wife? So it is a debatable subject, and court has given significant guideline on this, because Muslim marriage being equal to the nature of civil contract, and which can be broken off with the event of talaq or divorce or dissolution of marriage, and liability in general as per Muslim law, and when amount of mehr is paid to the wife, both are independent free. However, to consider equality and the current socio-economic condition with amount of mehr, it is very difficult wife to survive for long time at her own. So there is section 125 of CRPC. This section say that prior amendment of section 125 of CRPC, maintenance is only granted to only wife. So since there was wife word written and husband were taking support, that after divorce she is no more wife, she is divorced, so it is not applicable. However, court later on clarify, and it was amended, the divorce wife means divorce wife as well. So afterward, definition of wife include divorce wife also. So now husband cannot escape from giving maintenance to divorce wife as per section 125 of CRPC. However, there was one flaw in section 127 sub clause 3 of CRPC, which said that if a woman get any customary payment after divorce, husband will not be responsible for maintenance. Again confusion started. So husband were taking support of this clause that they have paid hake mehar, and now as per section 127 3 of CRPC, they are not liable to pay maintenance to their divorced wife. The next stage came when court recognized mehar as some mentioned in 127 sub clause 3, but held that it should be fair and reasonable. So it is not that you are giving 10 dirham or very small amount and now you are free. So it should be reasonable and fair. So this was held in case of Bai Fatima versus Ali Hussein in 1979. Another stage came when court further broadened the scope and held that whether mehar is paid or not, husband is liable to pay maintenance to his divorced wife, and held that mehar is not included in section 127 sub clause 3. So they again broaden and make strict clarification. So now husband cannot take benefit, and they also court also mentioned the explanation of Holy Quran Surah 2 and ayat number 241 and 242 to signify that it is a religious duty of a Muslim husband to provide reasonable maintenance to their divorced wife. And this matter was set aside forever in leading case of Sahabano Begum versus Muhammad Ahmad Khan in 1986. As you may be aware, that Sahabano was given talaq by her husband at the age of 60 plus, when she is not having any source of income, and very small amount of mehar is not sufficient for his her survival, then court took a particular stand and clarified this matter for once and all. However, what happened? Then government enacted one law in the name of Muslim Women Protection of Right of Divorce 1986. And in this law, there was a loosely drafted section which tell that it is section 3 which created confusion that provision of maintenance to be made within period of iddat. Then again husband taking benefit that as per this act of 1986 they are responsible to make provision of maintenance only within iddat period. Now in the case of Daniel Latifi versus Union of India in 2001, this matter came and court again clarify and set it aside, and as he held, so Supreme Court held that a Muslim woman is entitled for maintenance beyond iddat period. However, provision to be made within iddat period only, and this is for later on as well. So this is fixed formula for to how much should be maintenance. This is also again question. So there is no fixed formula. However, the maintenance should be around 30% of the husband's salary. A wife is entitled to get 30% of the husband's salary in case of maintenance. The next is, what about maintenance of children? So any father is a part of the maintenance of wife is also liable or bound to maintain his sons until they attain age of puberty, means age of majority as per Muslim law, and his daughters until they are married. Once they are married, they will go to the their husband, and then no responsibility. However, father is also responsible for upkeep of divorced daughter or widow daughter and their children also. So this is also uniqueness in Muslim law. Father liability is extended to the divorced or widow daughter as well. However, father is not bound to provide separate maintenance for his children in following circumstances. If minor or unmarried daughter who are refusing to stay with him without reasonable cause, in such case he can deny maintenance, or he can deny maintenance to adult son as well until such son is infirm or indigent. In case he is incapable, then yes, he has to give maintenance, otherwise he is not bound. And third one is, a son capable of maintain him from his own property. For example, if son is having his own property in his name and he is capable to maintain, then father is not bound. However, if father is infirm due to any case, then mother or other relative are bound to maintain children. So children to be maintained by someone, either by husband, if he is infirm, then by mother, otherwise with other relatives. What about maintenance of illegitimate children? So though children are illegitimate, father is not bound to provide maintenance to such illegitimate children as per Muslim law. However, there are some provision in Criminal Procedure Code 1908. As per section 488, in case mother is refusing to surrender the son to the father, still as per this section 488, father is bound to pay reasonable sum for the maintenance of that son as well as mother's also. I hope the maintenance part is clear to you. Thank you very much for watching this video. For any query or question, please mention comment so that I could reply. Thank you very much. Please subscribe, like and comment the video.